Hi guys, for this video we'll be making Adeline baby doll top. And if you're looking for something simple and classy look, this is the perfect project for you. Also, feel free to comment down if you want to see more of this type of crochet tops, and I'll be making them in the future. So here is the front and back view, and here is the list of the materials. This top has 4 parts, which is the chest part, the ruffled part, the straps, and the sleeves. The sleeve part is optional and you can make this top sleeveless. Now we will start with the chest part. For the chest part, I will be using 2 5-ply milk cotton yarn. Start with the slip knot and then chain 21. After 21 chains, single crochet on the second chain from the hook, and you will continue on making single crochet on each stitch. Continue until you reach the end of the row. Next, we will start on making double crochet rows. Chain 2, turn. Make double crochet on the very first stitch, and then continue on making double crochet on each stitch. By the end of the row, there should be a total of 20 double crochet. Again, let's make another row, chain 2, turn. Double crochet on the very first stitch, and then continue on making 1 double crochet for every stitch. Basically, you will just repeat the steps on making double crochet rows. At the start of every row, you will make chain 2, turn, and then double crochet on the very first stitch, and you will continue on making double crochet until you reach the end of the row. You will make a total of 63 rows of double crochet. At the end of the 63 double crochet rows, we will make 1 last single crochet row. Next, chain 1, turn, and you will make 2 single crochet per row of double crochet. Remember that it should be only 2 single crochet for every row of double crochet, just like in the video. Do this until you reach the other side. Now we're done with the chest part, I switch into a 4-ply milk cotton yarn. Let's start by chain 2, turn, and then make 1 double crochet for every stitch. Remember to hide the excess yarn within the stitches. Continue on making one double crochet per stitch until you reach the other side. Next, for row 2, chain 2, turn, you will make 4 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, and 4. On the 5th stitch, you will make a front post double crochet. So after the front post double crochet, you will just repeat the same pattern. Make 4 double crochet, 1, two, three, and four. On the 5th stitch, make front post double crochet. And you will repeat this pattern until you reach the end of the row. Now that we're done with the row 2, we will proceed with row 3. Chain 2, turn. Since we ended with 3 double crochet from the previous row, we will just copy the 3 double crochet on this row. So in the previous row, we made front post. In this row, we will make back post double crochet. Now, we will repeat the pattern 4 double crochet, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then we'll make back post double crochet. It is aligned with the previous front post double crochet. Again, let's repeat 4 DC. 1, 2, 3, and 4. On the 5th stitch, make back post double crochet. Repeat this pattern until you reach the end of the row. For the next row, chain 2, turn. We will just repeat the 4 double crochet and the front post double crochet. 1 double crochet, 2, 3, and 4. On the 5th stitch, make front post double crochet. Again, let's repeat the pattern. 1 double crochet, 2, 3, and 4. On the 5th stitch, make front post double crochet. Repeat this pattern until you reach the end of the row. So here's how the details will look like with the use of front post and back post double crochet. Now let's proceed with the ruffles. We will connect the both ends. Watch the video closely so you can follow on how I connected the both sides. Chain 1. Now let's start with the round 1 with the ruffles. For this round, we will be only working on the front loops of every stitch. Make 1 SC on the first front loop, then 2 SC on the second front loop. The 2 SC on one stitch will be called increase. Again, using front loops only, make 1 single crochet on the second front loop, make 2 single crochet. You will repeat this pattern all around. One single crochet on the first front loop and two single crochet on the second front loop. Now at the end of the round, we will always end with a slip stitch on the first stitch. Round 2, chain 2. Make one double crochet on the next two stitches. One and two. On the third stitch, you will make an increase or two double crochet on one stitch. Again, for the next two stitches, make one double crochet. And then on the third stitch, make an increase or two double crochet on one stitch. Repeat this pattern all around. Again, end this round with a slip stitch on the very first stitch. For round 3, chain 2. Make one double crochet on the next three stitches. And on the fourth stitch, make an increase or two double crochet on one stitch. Again, one double crochet, two, and three. On the fourth stitch, make two double crochet on one stitch. Repeat this pattern all around. As you can see, the ruffle is starting to show and it will look like this. End the row with the slip stitch on the first stitch. Chain 2. For round 4, there will be no increase. Just make one single crochet for every stitch until you reach the starting point. And you will just make slip stitch at the end of the round. You will repeat this round for 3 times, but you can add more rounds if you want your top to be longer. So here's how the ruffles will look like, and we're now on the 50% progress of the top. On the back part, you will attach the yarn here, and we will start on making single crochet within the edges. So first, attach the yarn. Make two single crochet for every stitch of double crochet. And when you reach this part, you will just make one single crochet for every stitch. It will look like this. Chain 1, turn. Again, you will make 2 single crochet for every row of double crochet. Continue on making single crochet until you reach this corner. In this corner, you will make chain 1 and you will turn just like what we did, and you will proceed on making single crochet. Now that we're done with the edging, we will make the part where we will attach the lace. Slip stitch on the first stitch, chain 3, skip 3 stitches, and then single crochet on the 4th stitch and the 5th stitch. Again, chain 3, skip 3 stitches, single crochet on the 4th and 5th stitch. Again, chain 3, skip 3 stitches, single crochet on the 4th and 5th stitch. Next, chain 4, skip 3 stitches, single crochet on the 4th and 5th stitch. The only difference here is we're making 4 chains instead of 3 chains. Again, chain 4, skip 3 stitches, single crochet on the 4th and the 5th stitch. With the last, chain 4, skip 3 stitches, single crochet on the 4th stitch. After that, chain 5, and then make single crochet on the last stitch. Chain 1, then cut the yarn. So here how it will look like. You will repeat the same pattern for the other side. Attach the yarn here and finish it all the way here. Next will be the straps, and get your 8 stitch markers. Start by counting here, and you will place your first stitch marker on the 16th stitch and second stitch marker on the 19th stitch. The 4th stitch marker will be placed on the 40th stitch, and the 4th stitch marker will be placed on the 43rd stitch. Do the same placing for the other side, and you will start counting here. So here's how the sleeve will look like, and I will show you how to make it. To start with the straps, attach the yarn. Chain 1, and then single crochet on the same stitch. Make 1 single crochet on the next 3 stitches. 1, 2, and 3. There should be a total of 4 single crochet. Chain 1, turn, make 1 single crochet on every stitch. Again, chain 1 for another row, turn, make 1 single crochet on the next 4 stitches. Repeat this pattern until you have a total of 73 rows. On the last single crochet, leave it with 2 loops because we're going to attach it on the back part. Watch the video closely on how I attach the strap on the back part. Next, single crochet on the remaining 3 stitches. 1, 2. And 3. After this, don't cut the yarn because we will proceed with the sleeve. If you want your top to be sleeveless, just add another strap on the other side and you're done. Now let's start with the sleeves. Chain 1, turn. Make half double crochet per 1 row of single crochet. Continue on making half double crochet per row until you reach the end of the strap. Next, you will proceed on making half double crochet per stitch. Continue on making half double crochet per stitch until you reach the starting point. Now that you reach the starting point, end it with a slip stitch on the first stitch. Chain 1, remember to always start with a half double crochet on the same stitch. Chain 1 again, skip 1 stitch, and make half double crochet on the second stitch. Chain 1 again, skip 1 stitch, and then half double crochet on the second stitch. Repeat this pattern all around. At the end of the row, chain 1, and then slip stitch on the first half double crochet. For the next 10 rounds, you will just repeat the same pattern. Chain 1, half double crochet on the same stitch, chain 1, skip 1 stitch, then half double crochet on the top of the previous half double crochet. Repeat this pattern until you reach the end of the round. Repeat this pattern all around to slowly form the sleeve. Again, always end the round with chain 1 and then slip stitch on the first half double crochet. So after 9 rounds, it will look like this. Next, for round 13, chain 1, make 1 half double crochet on each stitch. 1 half double crochet on the chain 1 space and 1 half double crochet on top of the half double crochet. Repeat this all around. Again, to end this round, slip stitch on the first stitch. As for round 14, we will start on decreasing. Chain 1, single crochet on the first stitch, and then make invisible decrease. Get the two front loops and then make 1 single crochet. Repeat the same pattern, 1 single crochet and then invisible decrease. Repeat this pattern all around. Again, at the end of the row, make a slip stitch on the first stitch. Chain 1. Make 1 single crochet on the next 3 stitches. 2 and 3. And then make an invisible decrease. Get the 2 front loops and then make 1 single crochet. Again, 1. Two, three, and then make a decrease or get the 2 front loops and make 1 single crochet. Repeat this pattern all around. Finish the round with a slip stitch on the first stitch. For rounds 16 to 18, just make 1 single crochet on every stitch. Always start with the chain 1 and end with the slip stitch. Now to end the sleeve, slip stitch on the first stitch and on the next 2 stitches. Chain 1 and then cut the yarn. Now that we're done with the 2 sleeves, we will add the last detail. Get your darning needle and cut a not so long and not so short strand of yarn and follow the steps on how you will add the last detail. If you don't want to add the last detail, you can skip this and your top is officially done. And now we're done. Thank you for watching. For more videos, feel free to subscribe. And if you manage to take a picture on your finished project, feel free to tag me on IG so I can see your finished project. Thank you!